Hello and welcome to the Sichuan Water Sports School, the venue for the rowing regatta at the World University Games. The gold medal contests continue here with the men's four. The start list: Czech Republic in lane one, Poland in lane two, the People's Republic of China in lane three, Italy in four, Turkey in five, and South Africa in six. Three seconds, 31, the difference between China and Italy in second position. Italy's four includes Alessandro Timpanaro, Alexander Gergele, Gustavo Ferio, and the stroke, Riccardo Mattana. They've proven to themselves over the course of the heats that they are the fastest boat on the water in the men's four. And that confidence is coming through at the moment. No pressure being applied to this Chinese four. And they can relax into the stroke rate that they most prefer at this point. They aren't being asked to push the agenda any further. They might be looking to elongate their stroke a bit. Got to keep an eye on where they are in their lane though. Drifting over ever so slightly to the right hand side. They correct themselves now, the Chinese. Italy followed by Turkey, who have moved up into third position now. The Turks and Ahmet Kabadeyi, Kain Aydin, Aydin Sahin and Ulas Kurt are the four for Turkey. China rowing towards their second gold medal. It'll come in the men's four, leading from early on in this race. It's China from Italy. Turkey coming in third position with a good bronze medal. Yes, thumbs up for all in the boat. Display of what's possible in Chinese rowing that we're seeing at these World University Games. Second gold now, 6.09, 3 seconds ahead of Italy. The medalists in the men's Coxless four: gold to the People's Republic of China, silver to Italy, and bronze to Turkey. The women's four final is next. And here is the start list: USA, Italy, People's Republic of China, Poland, and the Netherlands. Zhu Yingzhe, the stroke, still asking her mates to set as fast a possible stroke rate as possible. And they're looking quite comfortable with it. Wang and Liu in seats two and three, providing the power in the engine room. And you have to say that Zhong Xuxian must be doing a brilliant job in the bow to stabilize the boat. It's one of the advantages that Chinese rowers will have competing here, is that everyone is using Chinese branded boats, and they will be more familiar with how to keep them level than some of those other nations who are trying them for the first time here. 1500 meters. And Poland might be looking behind them rather than ahead of them here. The Netherlands in third, Italy in fourth. The Dutch working on second, however, and Poland might not be able to hold them off. The Chinese with a significant advantage. Almost 8 seconds over Poland. Still, the boat speed is good and still it's quite level. Not bobbing and surging as we see sometimes in the final 500 meters. The Dutch are moving up on Poland for second position. The Netherlands trying hard for this silver medal, but it's almost effortless, seemingly, for the Chinese. They're going to take this at a canter. Gold medal for China in the women's four, and a third gold medal of the regatta so far. Poland are going to hold on and hold off the Dutch. Silver for Poland there. Excellent form in the regatta continues, as much as they would have liked the gold. And the Dutch have a bronze. Italy coming in fourth. The medalists in the women's Coxless four. The gold medal to the People's Republic of China, the silver medal to Poland, and the bronze medal to the Netherlands. It's now time for the women's double sculls A final. Italy, Australia, Lithuania, Poland, Czechia, and the People's Republic of China in the six lanes. The fastest qualifier was Lithuania. They go in lane number three. Lithuania ahead of Poland in terms of times from qualification. Poland in lane number four. It's a slightly better start for Lithuania over Poland. Here is Czechia at the halfway mark. It is a decisive enough lead for Lithuania. 3 minutes 30 as they go over halfway. Italy still holding on to third, but Czechia have designs on not just their positioning, but also Poland as well. So real tussle for second, third and fourth. Out in front, however, Lithuania are ahead and they will stay ahead. Italy and Poland virtually level pegging. Czechia having dropped back now, so the fight for second and third is hotting up. Italy coming very fast. Lithuania still holding on to first. And they'll close this out, the Lithuanians. Second gold of the regatta. Ugne Juzunate, Martina Kaluskate. That was so close. The medalists in the women's double sculls, Ugne Juzunate and Martina Kaluskate from Lithuania. Paulina Konowska and Elizabeth Galek from Poland. The silver medalists and the bronze medalists from Italy, Khadija Alagi and Gaia Colasante of Italy. The men's double sculls final. Everyone under starters' orders. Lithuania, Hungary, Poland, Germany, Italy, and China. And away we go. Poland and Germany, the two fastest qualifiers. Poland in lane three with Bartosz Bartowski and Krzysztof Kasparek. But Kasparek and Bartowski leading for Poland in lane three. Germany's Sydney Garbers and Aaron Efanian in second position for Germany, and Ni Zhulin and Chen Wei Chun, despite their exertions this morning, they're in third at the moment. Lithuania in fourth might well be able to spring something in this final 400 metres. Poland having led from pretty much the outset. Kasparek setting a high stroke rate and wanting to elongate those strokes to get every piece of boat speed out onto the water as they try and fend off Germany and China and Italy. And Cangelossi and Gaioni might move into contention if they've got a finish on them. Lithuania have definitely got a finish on them. Look at lane one, moving up on Germany, moving up on Italy. Poland, however, still with that lead. But Lithuania might have them in their sights. Kasparek and Bartowski can see exactly where the duo of Jusevicius and Morocco are, and they can keep an eye on them from there. They're pulling for home now. Poland looking for another gold medal, a third of the regatta. If they can get this, they're going to take it. Lithuania coming in second. Was close between Germany and China, and in fact it's the Chinese who have got it. The gold medal to Poland's Bartosz Bartowski and Krzysztof Kasparek, the silver medal to Lithuania's Mantas Juskevicius and Domantas Morocco, and the bronze medal to China's Ni Zhulin and Chen Weichun. Now time for the lightweight women's double sculls final. The starters: Australia, South Africa, Japan, Italy, the Netherlands, and Hungary. And it is a medal-winning Italian boat from 2 weeks ago at the World Under-23 Championships, because Borghi won an Under-23 bronze with Elena Sali, and Corazza in the stroke seat at the front won silver in the women's single sculls in Bulgaria. So they have recent success, and they're planning on a little bit more here in Chengdu. So Borghi and Corazza for the Italians against Mai Kadoya and Chika Yonezawa from Japan. Japan yet to secure a medal in the rowing regatta here in Chengdu. They've had very few opportunities to even do so. So Kadoya and Yonezawa looking to secure the highest quality medal they can in this race. Italy yet to win a gold medal. The Italians having taken three silvers and one bronze so far. And the Dutch behind them have one of each tint. One gold, one silver and one bronze. And the Japanese looking composed at this stage in the race. Might be planning on upping the stroke rate for the final 500 metres. And they'll have to go some way to haul this Italian duo back. Corazza and Borghi both have races already in the tank today. So fatigue might play more of a factor in their final 500 than in the other boats. Won't be a problem for the Japanese. This is their only race of the day for Kadoya and Yonezawa. 400 metres from the finish line, and still that gap maintains for Corazza and Borghi in the Italian boat. Japan in second. The battle for third is most interesting. South Africa and Nadia Gasperi and Chloe Cresswell are edging in on the Netherlands' Ariane Putz and Kika Banning. At the moment, it's the Dutch who still lead in the battle for third. Up front, Italy out in front, but Japan showing a hint of encroaching in on that Italian boat. Still a length of difference, but it's reducing ever so slightly. Borghi and Corazza looking to hold on over the final 150 metres. Corazza won't like the look of Yonezawa and Kadoya moving up and closing in on them in these final 50 metres of the race. The lightweight women's double sculls and Italy are heading for the gold medal, their first of the regatta. Japan pushing hard, but it's the Italians who take it. Corazza and Borghi bring home the gold for Italy. The first medal of the regatta for Japan. And what a performance from South Africa. Second medal of the day, Nadia Gasperi and Chloe Cresswell securing bronze. The lightweight men's double sculls final. Turkey, Hungary, Japan, Germany, Italy and Austria already in waiting. And for the first time, the rain has started to pelt it down, as it can do in Chengdu. Germany and Japan, the two fastest qualifying nations in the centre lanes. And these are testing conditions indeed. With the humidity what it was, the rain will cool down the bodies of the athletes somewhat, but it adds a whole nother level of difficulty with the slippery nature of grasping the oars. It was already difficult given the sweat involved, but for Germany and for Finn Walter and Richard Moore, things have just got a whole lot trickier. However, they are the second fastest qualifiers by just a few split seconds when they won their heat over the previous couple of days. So Germany leading at the halfway mark. In second position, the Italians, Giovanni Borgonovo and Matteo Tonelli. Well, they are the chief chasers here. Borgonovo, he's in the bow seat. He won the under 23 single sculls world championship last week. And look at the distance that the Italians are able to claw back on Germany. The Italians had a very poor heat 2 days ago. They only finished third, but they rode 10 seconds faster than that in their repechage to post the fastest time on the water across the 3 days. They were even a few split seconds ahead of the Germans. So they know that in the same conditions, when things aren't raining, they can do it. Can they do it in these testing conditions? It's a complete change to the morning we've seen so far, which has been overcast but extremely hot. And just gripping the oar in this environment is going to be so hard, especially as we enter the last 500 meters and the sweat adds up, combining with the water. Terrific race at the front. Austria at the back with Japan and Hungary and Turkey. Well, they're all vying for third. But the race for gold is on. Italy chasing down Germany. Italy's Matteo Tonelli there, stroke. He's already got a race under his belt earlier today, but he's got to start moving up, setting a higher stroke rate. Because Walter and Moore, as close as they are to Italy, have been comfortable so far. But look at this from Italy. Tonelli and Borgonova are saying, "I see you, Walter and Moore, and we'll see if we can catch you." Under 200 metres left in the lightweight men's double sculls. Walter and Moore. Are they heading for victory? Walter just struggling a little bit to keep hold of his right oar with that right hand. Italy have drawn themselves up to very close indeed to the German bow. And Tonelli and Borgonova are starting to move here, and they've moved into the lead with 20 metres remaining. Can Walter and Moore respond? The Italians are going to take victory over Germany in the final 50 metres. It's gold for Italy. And Tonelli smashes the water in the most testing conditions here in Chengdu. Germany beaten at the very last. The bronze medal is secured by Hungary. Giovanni Borgonova and Matteo Tonelli have won the gold. The silver medal to Germany's Richard Moore and Finn Walter, and the bronze medal to Hungary's Bence Jarboe and Kalman Furker. Time now for the women's eight final. Just three boats in the race. China leading from the Netherlands. And the Netherlands eight on the bow is Anna Leerink. In the middle crew, it's Van Mierlo, Marije Ijima, Ruta Wier, Nienke van Heibel, Lisanne van der Leege, and the stern pair is Martha Dahmen and, as mentioned, Floor van Amde. The work of this China 8 so far is exemplary. The stroke Wu Yihui, the stroke should be the most competitive, the most powerful, the most decisive of the rowers in the eight. And there's no lack of decision making about what to do for China. They wanted to go off the front, and they have done from the very beginning. But they aren't cutting the Dutch loose, which might be a surprise to them. The Dutch are making some inroads on this Chinese leading boat, but with 150 meters to go, it is the Chinese who are ahead. A little too close for comfort for them over the Dutch, you sense, but China pulling for a fourth gold medal at the World University Games. They were a little slow to get going this morning in picking up medals, but my goodness, they've hit their stride. And that is never more true than in this women's eight. From start to finish, it's a gold medal for China. The silver goes to the Netherlands, and Italy will have the bronze. Just three nations in this final, but only two contesting for that gold medal. Congratulations to the Chinese. A fine race in difficult old conditions, these. Now getting ready for the final medal contest of the whole regatta at the World University Games. The men's eight, and here's the start list. Italy, the People's Republic of China, the Netherlands, Germany, and the USA. Up to the halfway mark. The Dutch with a full length now on Germany, but Germany really close, tussling things out with the Chinese, and Italy now moving up as well to throw themselves into contention. The USA, well, they are cut a little bit adrift at the halfway mark. Just 0.4 of a second between China and Germany in second and third. It's the Netherlands who have led from the very start, looking for a second gold medal of the regatta. And no Dutch crew have looked as composed and as in charge of a race as the men's eight do so far. Here we go into the final 500. The Dutch leading China, and Germany tussling for second and third, changing the order somewhat. The Italians are still there, but they are being pushed back a little bit as we wait for the USA to come over and into the final 500 meters of the final race in the World University Games Rowing Regatta. It's been glorious sunshine for 2 days and about 4 hours of this morning. It's been utterly glorious on this lake, and then the rain has come down and made these final few races very difficult for the rowers. 200 meters left to race. The German cox, Till Martini, asks for a little bit more, demands a little bit more. The Dutch in the lead, China in third. The Netherlands from Germany, from China, the top three. Italy come after that. But this Dutch eight have led from the very beginning. It's a composed and smooth row. The Netherlands are going to take their second gold medal of the day. Germany, try as they might, are going to bring this home in silver. And the Chinese will have to settle for the bronze. It's gold for the Dutch, silver for Germany, and China with that bronze medal. Italy coming in fourth. Netherlands 5:35, that time that they stopped the clock at. The medalists in the men's eight. The gold to the Netherlands, the silver to Germany, and the bronze to the People's Republic of China.